The Yupik name for this island is Siboko. Which means the creator reached into the sea floor and rinsed it out, or wrung it out. That's what it means. Wrung it out or rinsed out. You know, you could, if you see it, the right hand print, the palm is where we are. I'm not in a rush to destroy such a beautiful place. Why develop it when we have everything we need right here?
St. Lawrence Island is located right in the middle of the Bering Sea. And it's a breeding ground for all marine mammals.
Whales, walrus, seals, polar bears, fish. Our way of life since time immemorial, living off the land, living off the ocean. Our biggest food security is from the Bering Sea. With all this Northwest Passage opening, the biggest concern was noise and pollution from the ships. So we feel and believe that, you know, the noise is already making an impact. We've noticed that the whales are moving further away, the walruses.
One of the issues is it's the Bering Strait. You know, it's a narrow passage through which lots of animals migrate every year. So that's a natural point of interest. We want to know when animals are passing through the Bering Strait.
When we come to games, we have to be quiet. You have to be idle in the boat, and you dip the oar in the water and you put it in your ear like this, and you can hear the sound.
So sound propagates in the ocean much better than light does, and marine mammals who evolved in the marine environment have used this property of sound. They can use sound to find mates, to keep contact with their offspring, and so it's very important for marine mammals. So we go out on a boat and we deploy these instruments in the bottom of the ocean. They're anchored to a heavy weight, and we just drop them off the boat, and they're tubular shaped, about this size, and they have tiny little electronic circuits inside them. We do all the recording, and they have a hydrophone attached, an underwater microphone.
You know, you don't have to be a rocket scientist to know that sound goes further in the ocean than it does in the air.
In Savoonga, I hear Hondas, I hear people, and here I hear nature. I hear the waves, and I hear me, and the birds. That's what I hear.
And so any noise that's added to the environment has the potential to disturb this communication and impact these animals in a negative way. And to assess the impacts of these changes, we need to have a baseline. And so the part of the work that we're doing is establishing that baseline so we can compare changes in the future, so you know how much things are changing, how much are animals being displaced, how much more noise is being added to the environment.